call duration is the same.
Nokuthi ke kwathatha isikhathe singakanani ke nalapho ke isikhathe sodwa.
Thank you. Now let's come to the other party. What is your comment?
The other party on both lines differs on both exhibits.
Uma sesiza lana ke manje komunye ke lona ukuthi lona oshayelwe noma kuyena ke oshaye ucingo kumazibithi omabili ke kuma line omabili esihlukile ke lokhu obhalwe la nalokhu obhalwe ngale.
By the way, this other party in respect of this column, in respect of the call that was made, is the one who made the call.
The other party, yes.
Kumakhulunywa lana ke ngo other party noma omunye lona ke uyena ke owashaya ucingo.
Let us start with exhibit 3JG1. Is it J or G?
J.
Thank you. Let us start with the other party on 3JG1. What is the number there?
The other party number is on 3JG1 is 27 83 457 1330.
Thank you. And what is the other party on exhibit 02? On the first column.
And the other party on exhibit O is
27 73 305 9202.
Now, what is the other party on the second line in exhibit 3JG1?
27 71 437 9551.
Ma siya kubuyela ke na ke u3JG1 u other party ke khona lapha ke noma omunye ke lona kwaqhunyana naye ke kwaku 27 714 379 551.
And what is the other party in exhibit 02 in line number 2?
27 73 305 9202.
Bese kuthi ke ku line 2 ka exhibit 02 u other party noma omunye ke u 27 73 305 9202.
Thank you. Now, as I said, man, and with due respect, I'm going to request to tap into your wisdom, being an expert in data analysis. Now, we can see that in respect of the column of the other party, in both exhibits, there's a discrepancy, not so?
Siyabona-ke ukuthi lana-ke kwamazibiti amabili-ke uma sekhulunywa lana ngomunye-ke lona okuyena-ke ekwaxhunyana naye-ke ukuthi-ke ukhona-ke kwahlukana akusiyena umuntu oyedwa wahlukile.
But now, in respect of all the other columns, the information is just exactly the same.
That is correct.
Kodwa-ke uma kukhulunywa ngeminye-ke imigalena noma amanye-ke ama-column lana-ke imininingwane noma information yona-ke iyafana noma-ke iyodwa.
You know, when I went through this information, I got tempted to call Mark Zuckerberg and say to him, how does this happen? And then something said, no, but we've got an expected call. Why should I worry to do an international call? Now, as I'm saying, may I kindly tap into your wisdom for an explanation on these discrepancies.
Please take note that I can only, my lord, I can only comment on Vodacom's set of data.
Yes.
And what I'm familiar with, as I know how and when the information was downloaded.
Mcela ke usichazeleke manje ukuthi kwenzeka kanjani ke lokho esikutholayo noma esikubonayo ke lana. Ngiyafisa ukuthi ngisho ke ngosenkantolo ukuthi mina ke engakhuluma ngako nekuyikona ke engikwaziyo ukuba Vodacom nokuthi ke imininingwane noma information lena ke itholakala kanjani noma sisebenza kanjani ke ngayo.
The information that you see in front of you under the table on JJJ1 has been extracted from the data that I would call the voluminous data, which comprises of pages 4,649.
Lama lea column ke noma lea table lana ngaphansi kwa Vodacom kuthathwe noma ke kukhishwe ke kule data noma kule mininingwane lena endala ma page awu 4,649.
If you...
Just before you proceed, is it not so that the data that is extracted from the data that comprises of 4,649 pages is the data that you personally worked on?
Yes.
Thank you.
Futhi ke le data engikhuluma ngayo ke ngama page awu 4,649 yilena yile mina ke engangisebenza ngayo.
And it originates the originators of this data, or it belongs to Vodacom.
Correct.
Thank you.
Futhi ke data lena ke eka Vodacom.
You can proceed with the explanation.
If you have page 1586 of 4,649 in front of you.
Uma ke phambi kwakho uno page 1586 kula ma page ke awu 4,649 phambi kwakho.
You will find towards the middle of that page.
I don't have that page.
Perhaps I could put it on the big screen.
Yes.
Not sure if you can see the highlighted portion in yellow.
I think
I need to come nearer. My eyesight is good. Sometimes it gets me down when I'm supposed to be seeing other things. Yes.
Okay. So this information is on page 1586, as I've indicated.
Now, that information is record that you worked on.
Yes, this forms part of the JJJ one exhibit.
Now, which is that information? Is the information, okay, you're saying it's in JJJ1. Thank you.
Perhaps if you could just give me a moment to explain.
Okay.
The entire set of data.
Thank you, ma'am.
So that you would then have a better understanding.
Let me do that. Thank you.
So the data that, the extraction that you see on exhibit JJJ1, the small block that I've just presented,
yes.
This page 1586 is, or has be, forms part of that extraction.
Yes.
And here...
Logo ebese ngikhulumileke ngakho ngaphambilini ekuyile table-ke encane la ebengifunda khona le mininingwane ke ekuyingxenye ke iyakho ke lokhu engikuthembisayo noma engikukhombayo ke laphana uku-highlightiwe. Yes.
As you can see that the MSISDN is the same on JJJ1, which is 27824435. The IMSI is exactly the same. It ends with 6061. The IMEI is the same. It ends with 3538. The date and the time is exactly the same, which is the 2nd of August 2014 at 22:40:47 seconds. The MTC is the same as this call type. The duration is exactly the same. However, you would then notice that under this highlighted portion, that this data reflects the number ending 1330. And that...
Just a minute. Uzobheka ke yonke le mininingwane asakhulumileke ngayo lena ke ebhaliwe laphayana MSISBN, EIMSI, EIMEI, isikhathi ke idate kanye nesikhathi ukuthi ke i-call yaluphile uhlobo i-MST. Ama-seconds ke awu-110 ukuthi konke ke lokho kuyafana kodwa uzobhaphela-ke manje uma sesifika laphana kuleyanganye-ke ukuthi inumber elaphana ile ethinambe 1330
You would find that exact same number which is under other party on page 1586 and that also reflects under other party on exhibit JJ1.
Lana-ke esekhulunywa-ke manje-ke ukuthi omunye lona-ke obekuxhunyanwa naye-ke noma-ke lokho kubhalwe other party khona-ke la ku-JJ1 ekuyena-ke lo aphethe-ke khona la esandleni ukuthi-ke yena-ke noma-ke yiyona-ke leya number futhi-ke ekhona-ke noma ebhaliwe laphayana ku-other party.
The only information that we don't have on page 1586 is the LAP number. We do, however, have the cell ID, which is identical to the cell ID, which is 27009. And then on JJ1, we do not have the tower name, whereas on page 1586, we show Kimberly MW underscore CEN, which then reflects as the data on exhibit O.
Esingenako-ke lana-ke kulokhu yiloku esikutholayo-ke lana ku-JJ1 okubhalwe LAC loko kuthiwa-ke yi-LAC kodwa-ke i-cell ID yona-ke iyona-ke ngamashi ekuyile eku-27009. Bese musuyabheka-ke futhi laphayana-ke i-tower yilena-ke ekhona la iyatholakala la exhibit O2 yileya-ke ebhaliwe laphaya ekuwukhibali MWCEN.
Thank you, ma'am. Maybe just before we proceed.
Okay.
Now, would the fact that your table on the first line has that LAC number being number 37, and the fact that exhibit O does not have that LAC number, and the fact that your exhibit JJ1 does not have the cell name, and the fact that exhibit O has a cell name, have any effect on who the other party should be?
No.
Thank you.
Not at all. The LAC and cell number or cell ID relates to the tower.
Thank you.
Nothing else.
But logo go kutike lana ke kuwena ke kuno LAC noma ke u LAC angabi khona ke u LAC lana ke kuloko okutshengisayo ke khona la futhi ke nala ku O2 nokuthi ke kuno cell name la ku exhibit O2 akekho la kuwena ukuthi ke lokho kunganomthelela yini ke ukuthi ubani omunye lo okwaxhunyana naye uthi cha ukuthi nje u cell name akushoyo kona ke usho nje uphela ke noma ukhuluma ngayo i tower.
Thank you, may proceed with your explanation.
Sure. So if we move on to the next number, it is also part of the big data, and that should be on page 1646 of 4,649.
Uma sesindlulela-ke manje kwenye-ke inumber, nayo-ke ikhona-ke lapho kupage 1646, kuwona-ke lama-page awu-4,649.
Coming back to exhibit JJ, my little block is the extract of what the data reflects on my computer and your big screen. It also indicates the same number ending 4358. The IMEI is the same, ending 6061. That was the IMSI number. The IMEI number is the same, ending with 7621. The date and time is exactly the same, 15th October 2014, 1733-57. The call type is exactly the same, which is an MTC. The duration is the same, 98 seconds. Difference is the other party, and this reflects, it's different from Exhibit 0. The number ending 9551 reflects on page 1646, and as well as Exhibit Triple J1, which is the extraction of this data. The LAC number does not appear. However, we have the same cell ID, and unfortunately, the tower name does not appear on Triple J1. It does, however, appear on Exhibit 0. Similar, Ivydale Farm, _Lim_-_2.
Mrs. Kubegage, Nalanage, Gwenage, page 1646, Lama page 4649. You say number, I get a yota, ekli nanga, 4358. IMSI number, I got shinjige, IMEI number, I got shinjige, ekli nanga, 7621. Date higabona, yonage, 15 October 2014, iskati, 1733, masekenza, 57. Colleague MTC Utige Yonaga number Eya Tolu Tringo, my second out 98. Lana exchange a conage Uguti Lanage, a good Triple J one in number, a yle equinango 9551. Engas Yonage Lena in number, a conage lago exhibit 02. Basic Baconage Nayoga is cell name La Payanagi, cell ID, Engashinjilege, Yonage Lea 10862, Nalana Econage, good Triple J one, Kotwage. Uzotholake ukuthi lana ke ilek ayikho lana futhi ke ingabikho ke nalana ke ku 02 kodwa ke uma ubheka lapha egcineni ibhalile Ivydale iTower ecoshayo 2G ifarm uyayithola ke lana ku exhibit 02.
Thank you ma'am, that is well appreciated. Basically what we've just explained now is to confirm the correctness of the information that is contained in your affidavit insofar as that little table is concerned. So thank you. But my concern still is, there is this also affidavit here, exhibit 02, that deals with the same information, but the number of the other party differs materially from the number that is contained in you. Now, I've struggled to find out how possible, how could this be, what could have happened here, why should these numbers be different when all this other information is the same. That is the kind of a wisdom that I would request you to assist us with.
So, as I've indicated yesterday, that our set of data is submitted in PDF format. Yes. It cannot be manipulated in any way by us.
Yes.
We submit it to the TSU,
yes,
or any other institute for that matter, in the PDF format.
Yes.
As you have seen, that this little block on Triple J1 is an extraction of the entire data.
Yes.
The only thing that I've left out was the tower.
Yes.
This comes from the old data. This is an enhanced statement with our new systems.
Thank you.
This cannot be changed in any way. It cannot be altered, added, another number inserted or a number removed,
yes,
or for that matter, a tower name, a cell or ID, a LAC or ID.
Yes.
I can only explain on what I've worked with and what I've provided.
Thank you.
However, this statement belongs to somebody else. I have no idea how that information was extracted, and therefore I cannot make any comments on that.
Minage engisekonake akashintshike ukuthi ke konke kunye lokhu kuyafana, yonke imininingwane ke iyafana, kodwa ke uma sesifika lana ke ku other party noma omunye lona ke ekwakhulunyisana naye noma ke ekwaqhunyana naye ukuthi yila kuhluka khona ukuthi kwenzeka kanjani ke lokho. Mina ke engakhuluma ngako engakusho iloku mina engasebenza ngako nezinhlelo noma indlela esebenza ngazo kwa Vodacom ukuthi ke information then asithola kanjani ke bese sisebenza ngayo ngalo hlobo ke noma ke le format abayibiza ngokuthi ke iPDF. Akukho esingakwenza ke kuyona ke leyo PDF format leyo, siyithola ikanjalo. Akukho ukuthi ungashintsha ungangeza enye inamba noma kube nenamba oyikhiphayo usebenza ngaloko okutholile onako nala esesidlulisela khona ke ku TSU ngaleyo ndlela esithole ngayo. Lesi statement esonake istatement somunye umuntu, angazi ukuthi basebenza kanjani. Akukho ke engakusho mayelana naso.
Thank you, ma'am. Most probably there will be an explanation forthcoming vis-a-vis the explanation that you've just given, that this information is untemperable. You can't tamper with it. You cannot edit it. You cannot alter it. No amount of change can be effected on the information that you have just testified about on as it reflects in your affidavit, JJJ1. Thank you, ma'am. In the course of the exchange of information, the state provided us with information which is in soft copies, in memory sticks. This is called information which is in here. It's a soft copy. So, yeah. Now, in this memory stick here, there is what I could identify as the data, cell phone data, of the number ending with 358. So I'm going to request you, actually my colleague here, Advocate Numalo, can come and assist there because he's also saving with the computers. So he can come and assist and just to go right into the information that we want. We otherwise do not want to get to other information that is contained in this memory stick. With the leave of court, my lord, may I request Advocate Numalo to go to approach the witness and assist.
Whose affidavit is it?
No, it's not an affidavit, man.
Which is it's her affidavit?
It's not about an affidavit, my lord.
No, I'm asking that information. Who made an affidavit to say he or she compiled it? The one you say, Mr. Numalo, will explain.
We've got two affidavits,
yes,
my lord.
That's why on the name.
No, I'm not saying Mr. Numalo, Advocate Numalo, should assist in respect of the affidavit, but access information that is in this memory stick.
I want to know, when you say this witness,
yes,
must assist, are you saying she must assist in her own affidavit? Which you say she was instructed to compile section 205,
yes,
data.
It works both ways, my lord.
No.
Let me explain.
Listen to me. Otherwise you're wasting time.
No, we're not wasting time, my lord, with your respect, but let me explain. This witness as well had the privilege to work on the cell phone data with the phone ending 358. Mr. Stein had also a privilege to work on a cell phone data with the number ending 358.
Yeah, that's the crux of the point.
Yes.
Wait, because she is saying, you are saying basically you can't compare, you can't explain how Colonel Steyn came to aggregate that information.
Correct.
That's what you say.
No, but now, my lord, I'm no longer pursuing the issue of the discrepancies as contained in the affidavit.
I want to proceed. Listen to me. I know whose affidavit is it. Is it her affidavit or Colonel Steyn's affidavit? That's all I want to know.
Which is in the memory stick?
Yes.
It is for both of them, because Mrs. Vitilingam also had worked on the number ending with 358.
Fine.
Yes.
Fine. The stick contains... Wait. You're saying the stick contains the affidavit of this witness and the affidavit of Colonel Steyn.
I did not get that, my lord. I just got a
picture. Say the stick contains the dual numbers which he worked on, Steyn worked on. Is that not so?
Yes.
Now, I want to know, which numbers is he going to comment on? Is it her own numbers in that stick which she comments on? That's all I want to know.
I think the court wants to know about the number, but I think the court wants to say affidavit. Is it her own affidavit that she will have to comment on or Steyn's affidavit?
Yes.
In this memory stick, there's no affidavit. It's just the data.
Yes, the data.
Yes.
Is she the one who compiled it?
Who compiled the data
in
this memory stick
that
we received from the state?
Yes.
This information does not reflect. However, we know at the back of our mind, and it is now on record, that at one point this witness was requested to work on an affidavit, on a number that ends with 358. Mr. Steyn as well was also requested to work
fine.
On a number that ends with 358.
Fine, go on.
Thank you, my lord. Does the court then give permission to let Mr. Nimaluko assist today? Can Nimaluko suffer?
So it's Mr. Nimaluko's turn to cross-examine this witness.
Maybe.
Hello?
Excuse
Procedure dictates that if you say Mr. Nimaluko is the one who will assist, you're actually saying he is now cross-examining this witness.
As it please the court.
Yeah.
Maybe the witness herself, because she's a technically well-read person, can access this information. In an event that she picks up some troubles here and there, that's when then we can jump in and assist, my lord. May I then hand this memory stick to the witness to open it?
My lord, I'm going to save Mr. Mnisi or Advocate Mnisi all of their trouble by stating that my ports are blocked due to security reasons. I cannot insert a memory stick from you or a disk from you or anyone else into my computer because of the confidentiality and the security constraints.
Ukuthi ngathatha istick lesi uadvocate Nisi afisa ukuthi ngisithathe ngisifake lana ke ngenxa yokuthi ke kunemini ningwane ke ethize lana akungivumelike ukuthi ngikwenze lokho.
My lord, no matter what, it is very imperative that this information should be flighted today. If there's somebody that has got a laptop that can assist us therewith, maybe we can use that laptop. I think the state does have a laptop. The court registrar does have a laptop. It doesn't matter whose laptop is it, but the explanation from the witness is understandable. For security reasons, that cannot happen, my lord. I will request, my lord, the court registrar to assist her with, to assist us. That's a bit of a tongue twister, my lord. To assist us with her laptop, so that we access this information.
I say you are not permitted by your employer.
No, the ports are actually blocked for the security reasons.
No.
Yes.
So nobody accepts?
No, nobody can access.
Paraphernalia of Vodacom can do.
Yes, and if I have to insert a memory card in there, it's going to encrypt it and throw it out, which is null and void.
Yeah, let's make progress. He says he's unable to do that.
That is understandable, my lord, which is the reason why I said maybe the state will be in a position to assist us, alternatively, the court registrar.
No, the court registrar is not a computer expert. You can't help. Hello, do you have any courses in computer science?
This does not require a computer knowledge.
No, I'm just asking.
Just a basic knowledge on computers.
He says he's lost, like me.
Madam, I can assist. I do have a computer in my car.
But you know what? We're wasting time. This witness, Mr. Dallingham, when first did we meet, by the way? How many years back?
Long time back, my lord.
I mean, it's over 20 years. She says it's not possible for her to do that.
May I request the state then to possibly assist us, my lord? The state does have
a Bando.
He has always been assisting us in any event, my lord. I don't think he can hide behind the fact that he's also hasn't done IT.
If at all, what is the position?
I will assist wherever I can. I just cannot insert anything into my computer.
Yeah, let's make progress. It's just he cannot.
I don't have a problem with that, my lord. But that cannot be the, it can't be a cul-de-sac. There should be alternative available. One of them is the state. One of them is the court registrar. The court registrar, the court has said she's not computer literate. But it does not look to me like she's not computer literate, my lord. But nonetheless, let us request Mr. Sibande to assist us. The court registrar is willing to make a laptop available.
Now, what is that supposed to be?
Thank you, my lord. That is what appears to be a download, a cell phone data of the number ending with 4358, not so many.
Yes.
Thank you. Now, when I say me, I mean myself and accused and my colleague here, Advocate Numalo. I want to be sincere with the court. We're analyzing that information. Something struck us very seriously and very amazingly. We're actually perturbed. As we're analyzing that data call there, it appeared to us that version is editable. Do you confirm that?
That is Excel. And
Excel, yes.
You can do anything with Excel.
It's excellent.
Excel.
That is Excel. Yes.
Lana, the Citabu Martina, the Citabu Martina, the Lumina Nayagi, who advocate Numalo Sakola, the Uti Lana, the Pumanagi, Pumabuza Lana, Uti Ebu, Tony, so Excel legal, no my program, and use of Uti Excel legal, who Excel Ungans and no my in.
Now, that is the version. That's the information that the state gave us. Now, when we went through it, we realized that cell phone data, it's a cell phone data that was supplied in terms of Section 205. But it is changeable. Somebody can do whatever that they want to do with that information there. Do you understand? And do you say yeah, and you also say yeah, no, that is it's alterable.
Excel is used for analysis purposes.
Yes.
In most instances.
Yes.
You know, it's almost like an accounting application where you make it work for you.
Yes. Then I understand.
Lana ke Excel lena esikhuluma ngayo ke okwenzela ke noma ke uma usebenzisa u Excel lo ukwenzela ke ukanela noma ke ukuhlanga ke kufana nje ukuthi ke uma usenza ke isicelo ke noma ke application yayo ke I accounting ukuthi ke ikusebenzele wena.
Thank you, ma'am. Now you are saying the information that you provided, that call data that you provided in terms of section 205 of the Criminal Procedure Act, it's applied in a PDF format. You cannot alter it, you cannot change it, no amount of tepitude may be done on it. It is as is, and it should always be as is.
Yes, we provide it as is in a PDF format.
Thank you.
Ngishilo ke ukuthi thina ke esebenza ngayo ke lokho obizwa ngokuthi ke PDF uyithola ikanjalo usebenza ngayo ngaleyo ndlela ke.
Then why is it that the one that is applied by you, which is similar to this one, is in a PDF format, such that somebody cannot change it or alter it or whatever? This one that has been supplied to us, which is similar to one, to the one that you dealt with, is editable.
Not answer that because I did not give that to you.
Kungani ke ukuthi lena ke wena ke osebenza ngayo ingale ndlela oyishoyo ke ukuthi akukho okungenziwa noma okungenzeka kuyonaka ngeke uzishintsheke bese kuthi lethi na ke esinyikiwe njengabameli ke ingafani ke noma ingekho ngale ndlela angikhokhi isimo sokuthi ngakuphendula le ngoba akusimina okunikile noma oninikile.
Thank you. Maybe let us go to the date of the 3rd of August, 2014. Hmm? 02 August, on that Excel format. No, don't go out. My lord, that advocate Sivande also is a litigant here, so he gets disturbed when he's going to operate the laptop and at the same time listen to what is happening here with a view to response. I don't think it's fair for the state. But if he's versatile and then it does not have a problem either, then it's fine. I was only noting that, my lord. That's on the on the 3rd of August. The time is 22:40:07. What is the date? Oh, on the 2nd of August. Yes. On the 2nd of August at 22:40. It appears, my lord, that in that data, this information, which is contained, the time on the 3rd, or I mean on the 2nd of August 2014, at 22:40:47, it does not appear as if that information is there. Not so. That information is not there.
Which information is that? Is that the one on the Excel?
The information that is on Exhibit O
Yeah.
On page 23.
Right.
Information that was compiled by Mr. Stain. On paragraph 4, that little table there, that information as it reflects on the first line of the 2nd of August 2014 at 22:40:47, that information is not easy. Is it there? At 22:40:47. No, that information is even not there. Let us go to the 15th of October. At 17:33. Yes. May you please highlight that information for us?
So just for the benefit of logic, this time 22:40, which you say the information is missing at 22:40, you say it's missing there.
I had a look at what has been beamed, my lord.
Yeah, fine. But I'm just saying at the hour 22:40. Whatever information you say it's missing because it's not categorized at 22:40.
What I'm saying, my lord, is the information.
Which information?
Yes, that is what I'm explaining.
That's it, yeah.
Thank you. The information that is in Exhibit O,
right,
of the first line,
right,
on page 23,
fine,
which should be at 22:40:47 seconds.
Okay, right. Let's talk.
Yes.
So that everybody understands. It's at 10 past. 22.
No, that is 22:11.
Yeah, fine. 22 is what?
22 is 10.
10 past.
No. It's in the evening.
Yes, at 10 o'clock plus.
My lord, the information is very specific.
No, fine. At what time?
That is 22:40:47 seconds.
So
in other words, it's 22 hours, 40 minutes.
It's 47 after 8 o'clock
seconds.
In other words.
Excuse me, my lord.
After 8 o'clock, so that everybody understands.
Yes, that is actually after 10.
After 10 o'clock?
Yes.
After the alleged murder has occurred.
No.
No, I'm just trying to understand.
No, my lord. This is not the date of the murder.
No. This fine. I'm just saying it's the said murder was about 8 o'clock to whatever.
Yes.
So you are saying that information may not correlate to the date of the murder. It's after 8.
No, but what I'm saying, my lord, is this information, which I have here,
yes.
I mean, which is on exhibit.
Right. Oh. Yes.
It says, There were calls that were made before and after the incident, and I still have to come to that.
Right.
On the 2nd of August 2014,
right,
this number ending with 202
right,
called the number ending with 358.
Right.
That information, this information which is here, is an extract from the information or from the table that is highlighted, I mean that is flighted here at court.
Right.
So what I want to do is to compare what is in this affidavit with what is being highlighted today.
Yeah, that's why me, as a finer of fact, that's why I'm interested.
Yes.
Was it on the date of the murder? Was it before the date of the murder? Was it after the date of the murder? So it's simple.
That is before the date of the murder, right, Malok. That is 2 August 2014.
Right. Before,
yes. But there are allegations here that are made.
Fine.
That the number ending with 202 made a call to the number ending with 358 on the 2nd of August 2014.
Right.
That is very crucial to this case, Malok.
Right.
Yes. That is why, that's the reason why we actually wanted to demonstrate this information that is being alleged here should actually be in the broader context of that cell phone data there, which is in terms of 200 and in terms of section 205.
And she is saying she's not able to explain that because she never provided that information. Yeah, so well, Mr. Nisi, you must find your own expert.
Yes.
You must find your own expert to analyze that data because she says it's not her data. She never compiled it.
No, but that is not how it works, my lord. This information is already before court here.
Fine.
Why should I then find...
Yeah, fine.
I am not requesting her to analyze it. I'm just requesting her to comment. She has already analyzed it.
Ms. Dalia, are you able to comment?
No, this is not the format that I submitted the data in.
Lana ke ukhuluma ngabo ke ukuthi ngizalumisa ukuthi kunale information ekhona ke lana ku 002 yekhuluma ngaye u 22 yange 2 August 2014 2240 47 engekho ke lana noma ke engabonakali lana eshoyo ke ukuthi the number e 27733059202 yaxhumana ke nale number e 27827044438 yashoke ukuthi ke yena ke actionary iformat le yena ke asebenza ngayo okusho ukuthi ke akukho angaphawula noma angakusho mayela nalokho.
Thank you. That is understandable, ma'am.
Yes.
As the court has requested, I'll try to find a Mark Zuckerberg on my own to come and deal with this information. But let us then go to what is the next date? The 15th of October 2014. The one that I said is there. 15th of October 2014. The time should be 17:33:57. Yes, that is there. I'm not requesting for your comment, man, because you realize that this is not your work. You can only comment on your work. Yeah, thank you. Now, what is being reflected today? What is just written there? I don't think you'll have a problem in saying what is written there or what is depicted there in reading what is written there, not so.
And the highlighted portion.
Yeah, I think it's marked. It's not yet highlighted. But I think that should be the last line, last but not one line to the end.
17:33:57.
Yes.
The duration is 98 seconds.
Yes.
I'm almost certain that's duration. And I'm sure the other number is after the duration.
Yes. What is that number?
27733059202.
Thank you.
Lana ke ekubhalwe khona ke 17:33:57 ngazo I 15 October 2014 esikhathi ke amasekenza u 98 omunye ke lona noma any number lena 27733059202.
Thank you, ma'am. Just a look at this information that I've just read, being a cell phone data that was provided in terms of section 205, does that correspond with on the date of the 15th of August 2014? Does that correspond with the information that you gave in your affidavit?
It's the 15th of October.
Yes.
That does not correspond with
Thank you.
The data that I have provided.
Loku ke okufunda ke lapha manje bangi 15th of October 2014 ngale sesikade esi 1733357 akuhambisani ke noma ke akuhlangani ke naloko mina ke enginako la phambi kwami.
Thank you. Now let me ask you this way. In the realm of cell phone data provision, do such circumstances occur?
Ingaba ke ekusebenzeni kwenu ke nama cell phones ke ingaba ke okanjena ke kuyenzeka yini ukuthi akusona ke into eyenzekayo noma engamane yenzeka.
And your answer is not. What your answer again?
It's not likely. So
thank you.
We do have duplication of calls, but not activities that do not reflect on the set of data.
Sinako ke lokho abathi ke ama duplicate noma kuphindaphinda kwama calls ke kodwa lokho ukuthi hayi ukuthi ke kungabike nokwenzekile ke noma ke ama activity angatshengiswa noma angavelike kwimininingwane noma kwi data.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I don't want to push you too hard, but is that not one of those issues that you went to school for, that you were taught to guard against being fraud, being the alteration of information, this which is what is happening here? Is that not one of those instances? When you compare what you worked on and what with what is reflected there and also reflected on Exhibit O, does that not really on a reasonable analysis of this information lead one to say there's a fishy smell here and a very horrible one? Is that not the case?
My lord, I don't think it's fair for me to actually admit that it is fraud. I cannot make that statement.
Kumina ke ukuthi ke ngathi ke lana uma ngibheka lokho ngibheke ke engisebenze ngakho ke mina ke ukuthi mina ngakhona nje noma ngabe isimo sokuthi ke ngathi ikhwabanisa lokho angicabange ukuthi ngaba into ke efe ukuthi mina ngikusho lokho noma kuphume kumina.
Let us use a more modest word. It could be a misrepresentation of facts. Is that not a misrepresentation of facts?
The witness has clearly said she did not provide that set of data, my lord.
That's not in dispute. I'm asking all these questions, ma'am, not to a lay person, but to a data analyst who has gone to school for it, who has got the legal qualification for it, who understand what fraudulent activities are. And a fraud goes along with uttering, not so. Is fraud, forgery, and uttering. And very extensively, you have told this court that your information is uneditable. And very extensively, you have also told this court that there's no any other institution which is able to generate information in terms of information that is requested in terms of section 205, if that is directed to Vodacom, except Vodacom. But here we have that information here. Is it difficult for you, ma'am, just to be honest with this court and say, you know what, the situation that is happening here, in as much as I don't want to comment about it, but there is something fishy here. Nobody is going to hold you accountable. So is that difficult to say?
This is the same information which is captured in Excel, in a program of Excel.
I didn't get the court, my lord, because I was in the process of talking in my mind.
It is a snippet of fraud.
Yes.
It is the same information which the witness says is captured on the system or the format or program Excel.
I need to understand what the court really says before I can respond.
Just explain to him what I'm saying.
I'm not so sure if the witness also understands what the court is saying.
She understands me.
Yes.
My lord, I will try my best to explain to Mr. Misi. So, the court wants to hear if this is the Excel version of the data.
Where does it come from, ma'am?
This is what you've received.
No, is it in? No. Maybe.
No,
let's put it this way, ma'am. I see that is an Excel data,
yes.
But who made it? Where does it originate from? Definitely, in as much as I received it, it cannot be coming from me,
yes,
or from Mr. Sibande, because this is what we received from Mr. Sibande. Yeah.
Yes. So the court wants to know if that was provided in Excel.
Yes.
That's what the court needs to know.
Yes.
So yes, well, is it provided in Excel or no, it's not? That's what the court wants to know.
Exactly.
Yes.
But the inquiry does not end up there. That which is now in Excel form, where does it originate from? Is it not from you?
That does not originate from me.
You gave them.
Yeah. I have provided the PDF version,
yeah,
of the data.
Yeah.
Excel has not been provided by me.
Yes. PDF, Excel.
The information that you provided in a PDF format and the information which is now in an Excel format, are they not the same? The large bulk of that information, except for the other party's numbers, are they not the same?
Well, clearly we have just established it's not the same. Firstly, it's in two different formats. And secondly, what I have on my data isn't reflecting on that. So we cannot say that it's exactly the same.
No,
and this witness, if you listen to this witness,
yes,
she says Excel is editable.
Yes.
Unlike PDF format, you can't change it, it's immutable. So there's a vast world of difference.
That is understandable. It's not in dispute, my lord.
And now, when you're saying that information doesn't correlate with information which you find in the PDF she supplied, she says she's not able to comment on that because it's not in the same format which she supplied to the state. That's why I'm saying you must engage an expert because we are running in circles.
No, we're not, my lord. We're getting somewhere.
We are.
Exactly. We're getting somewhere.
No. No way. We're just like a South African government. We're not going anywhere. Just right.
Ma'am, I know you are in a very difficult position. But let me sum up everything. Maybe just before I sum up everything, let us look at page number 23 of Exhibit O.
23?
Yes.
Okay. Got it?
Yeah, because in my summing up, I also want to include that information.
Sure.
The last part, one line reads, calls. May you please read it?
Calls made before and after the incident.
Yes. May proceed.
02 August 2014 and 15 October 2014.
Lanage amakhos enziwa ke ngaphambi nasemuva ke kwesigameko i2 August 2014 ne15 October 2014.
And we know that this incident took place on the 26 October 2014. And so.
Futhi ke siyazi ukuthi isigameko lesi senzeka ngazo i-26 October 2014 kuyiqiniso lobo.
These calls that are mentioned on page number 23, which you have just read now, are all calls that, if they were made, they were made on before the incident, not so?
Yes.
And this is my summary. On behalf of my accused, you basically not the recipient of what I'll be saying. This is just in the broader context of the fact that you are also a data analyst. Thank you. That this information that is contained on Exhibit 02, on paragraph 4, on that little analysis of the data, on the table there, constitute fraud, number one. And why do I say that? It is because it differs materially from the information that was prepared by an expert who is you, who has painstakingly explained how information is safeguarded in their system. How this fraud was committed, I don't know. But with the technology these days, everything is possible. Manipulation of information as it is happening here. That's my first point. You've got no comment.
No
comment.
Number 2. The purpose of this information on on exhibit 02, on paragraph 4, on that little extract of the table there, the sole purpose was to fabricate, or is to fabricate a case, to trump up a false case against accused number 5, to make it appear as if accused number 5, and are even very wrong here when they say after the incident, when their own information does not speak about after the incident. But nonetheless, it's a fabrication, a trumping up of a case against accused number 5 so that it appears as if accused number 5 did have a communication with the number ending 358, which number is said to be belonging to Kelly Khumalo. That's point number 2. Point number 3 is going to come. I'm done with point number 2. You don't have a comment?
No comment.
Thank you.
Okwesibili ke lana ke nanjengoba lana ke ku exhibit 02 kunale information ekhona ke ethi ummangalelo wesihlanuke waxhumana ke lana nale number e 358 number leyo ke abathi yekakhi eki number ekuyekakheli Khumalo ke nalapho ke ukuthi nje into nje ababeyakha ke lokho ukuveza nokuthi bonake basho ukuthi khona ke kwakukhona uXhumano kwakukhona kuyena ke number 5 kanye noKelly Khumalo nalapho ke uthi akukho engakusho.
Point number 3. This is also a villain endeavor by the state to fabricate or trump up a case against Kelly Khumalo herself that on this date she had a conversation with accused number 5. As that number that ends with 202, it's a number that belongs to accused number 5. That's an open secret. you probably don't have a comment on that as well.
No comment.
Na kuvunyeke futhi ke kambothi ke ukuthi ke umbuso ke lapha ukuthi nje benza ke nje into engekho noma bazama ukuthi ke into engekho bayenze into ekhona ke ngokuthi ngalelo langa lelo ke uKheli Khumalo waba nokuxhumana ke naye ummangalo wesihlanu ngoba ke izinto manje akusona ke imfihlo ke ukuthi le number igcina ngayo u202 inamba yakhe ke ummangalo wesihlanu uthi nalapho ke akukho ngabusho.
And finally, ma'am, that will be point number 4. You'll also not have a comment. We hold instructions that on the basis of this information, we need to approach our instructing attorneys with a view to go and lay a formal case of, a formal complaint against the compilers of this information on behalf of our accused. You also don't have a complaint. A comment.
Ukugcina ke futhi ke sicela ke bonake abamangalelo sibameleke ukuthi kuzofanele ke manje sibonake ama lawyer noma lokubizwa ngokuthi phecelezi ke ama instructing attorney ke ukuthi ke sihambe ke manje siyomangala ke simangalela bonake laba ekuyibona abahlanganisa wona lombiko olapho O2 nalapho ke akukho engakusho.
The basis of the charges of fraud.
Excuse me, my lord.
I thought you were going to lay charges of fraud.
I'm coming there.
Now it's a complaint.
I'm coming there, my lord.
I see.
Yeah. Okay. That complaint will be premised on fraud, uttering, and defeating the ends of justice, or an attempt to defeat the ends of justice. Because this information is misleading the court. Those will be the basis of that complaint. Thank you. You also don't have a comment.
Nokuthi ke kuzobe kuyinike lawo macala ke labo enenzabe niyobatheswa bona ke ukukhwabanisa ukuphazamisana ke kokusebenza komthetho kanye futhi ke nokhohlisa ke nalapho akukho engakusho.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am. Finally, you might probably be receiving a call in due course to come and re-explain the situation again after the complaint. Thank you. I've got no further questions to you, but thank you for your assistance.
Thank you.
A very brave one. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, Mr. Mamala, any cross? Yeah, let's go up to half past one. Okay, let's go up to half past one.
I also wanted to put my house in order, madam.
Which house now?
The papers before me, there are lots of exhibits.
Who's ready? Miss Shalala, are you ready for first examination?
No,
he wants to put his house in order.
I also still need to prepare my papers properly.
Okay, we come back at half past one.